lost him.
But I didn't see him move. He was just right there.
Well, the deer are a little quicker than we are.
Will he come back?
If we stop talking so much, maybe. It's okay. We weren't ready anyway.
What do we do now?
Look for a scrape.
A what?
Come on, if we get lucky enough, I can show you what I mean. Let's walk.
By 2043, they perfected the Sling Bolt 5, a non-lethal gun. The same range and the same accuracy as a traditional gun, but instead of a hot piece of lead, the SV-5 hits you with an electric charge, knocked you cold for an hour. Simple, harmless, revolutionary. By summer, the NYPD had test-piloted the thing with phenomenal results. Gun control advocates were giddy. Guns that could kill were no longer necessary, unless you were planning on going hunting or committing a crime.
Well, that is a scrape. It means that our buck will be back. And he probably hasn't gone too far.
How does this tell you all that?
Well, the deer are in rut. It's their mating season. The does give off something called pheromones, which drive the bucks crazy. Makes them act a little nuts.
Well, do we have those too? Pheromones?
Yes. Yes, we do. But you shouldn't exactly rely on them to find the love of your life.
Too bad. Sounds a lot easier.
See her?
See her.
Okay. Get your gun out. Right here. Okay, now. Steady. Just breathe.
Time was right. Democrats acted. They introduced a bill that would ban lethal guns in every city with a population over 2 million. And when the gun manufacturers came screaming to diehard Republicans like myself to stop this nonsense, I ignored them. The bill was gaining ground. I thought it might pass. And that meant that Bobby would have to veto it. Bobby got elected on the dime of the gun-toting right. And if he wanted a second term, he was going to have to toe that line. This was going to be his first veto, his first kill. And I wanted it to hurt. I never thought that he'd get shot over it.
Wait until you feel it.
December 7th, 1941.
Ask not what your country can do for you.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
We are caught in war, wanting peace.
An ever-expanding American dream.
We must go forward as one nation.
Disappearing man. Where were you yesterday?
I was here. Can't get much past the register.
Thought you were gonna come to Mondo's house. The girls' basketball team came to help christen his new hot tub. He missed a seriously good time.
I had to pick up a shift.
Well, how about tomorrow? A group of us guys, we're gonna head over to the ice pond party down at Red Clover.
I'm not sure I can make it.
Why not, man? Come on, I'm sure my dad is gonna let you swap shifts if you want. Come on, man, we barely see you anymore. The guys want you to go.
They said that?
Yeah, man. Look, man, we don't care that you can't run, all right? And we seriously don't care about that whole Missy thing. They're your friends. No reason to hide out.
Not hiding out? Just laying low.
You sure you're not laying down? Oh, Bogey in sight.
Great.
She broke up with you, right? Figure she can't just at least find another place to hang out where you don't work.
Yeah, for a Christian, Missy was never much for charity. I should go talk to her.
No, you shouldn't.
Small school. Gonna have to get civil again sometime. It's okay, I'm unarmed.
Hey, Jack.
Glad to see you're still eating here.
I didn't know if it was okay. I mean, you kind of get the place you work at in the divorce.
Listen, I just want to say hi.
I figured you'd still be hating me.
Hopefully we can be friends one of these days.
I hope so, too.
What up, Crutch? Oof. You're dressing this hot to Bible study? That is just wrong. Want to sit down, McCallister? Split some fries with us.
You two are together. Nice.
No, that's not fair. We only just started hanging out.
Oh, you waited a week. You know what? I'm glad for you. I'm sure you'll make each other real happy.
I already do.
Wait a minute. Only Sissy's castle.
Really?
No. I was just trying to psych you out. Oh, I can't play this weekend. I'm going hunting with a friend.
You mean to shoot animals?
Yeah. Well, that's part of it. We go every year. This year, he's bringing his son.
Really? How old is he?
I don't know. Maybe 14?
I didn't know that kids can hunt. It sounds like a real good time.
It is. I used to go with my father when I was a kid, up in northern Michigan. We'd go out at dawn. He'd let me make the coffee. And we'd go and look for deer.
Wow. Well, could I come?
What? On the hunting trip?
Yeah, would you take me?
Bobby, if I took you hunting, your mother would hunt me.
Look, what if I were to convince her?
What if you had a chance to win this game?
No, I am serious. If I were to get her to say yes, would you take me?
You must be joking. Come on. Spider-Man's black costume is Lacanian imago.
What? It's totally legit.
Oh, yeah, totally.
It's his dark other. Come on, it's Venom.
Please.
Got all of Spider-Man's capabilities and none of his moral restraint. Well, it's practically Lacan's definition of imago, but, you know, it's Amazing Spider-Man 300. You should read it.
Yeah, don't push it. You're not that cute.
Oh, really? I thought I was.
No. Nope, you're not. Oh, God.
What?
No, I just can't believe I'm with someone who plays full contact basketball.
I was elbowed in the face.
Oh, I almost forgot. I have a surprise for you.
It's not Amazing Spider-Man 300, is it?
Oh, I'm so sorry. No, and it's not for this time or definitely not for this place.
Really?
Mm-mm.
Well, I don't know if I'm good at waiting patiently. Hey, buddy.
Hey, Bobby.
Hey, don't freak out. Well, you guys are a couple.
I'm gonna, I gotta finish all this stuff at home. I left something there anyway.
Oh, okay.
Bye.
Bobby, did you get that English test back today?
Yeah, I got a 90.
Oh, that's fantastic. Good for you.
Mom, I was wondering, can I go away this weekend with Peter?
He's going somewhere?
Yeah. He's got this camping trip that he goes to every year with his friend and his friend's son, who's my age. He invited me.
All of a sudden? Well, where would you go?
The woods. Probably it is a camping trip.
I should call and find out the specifics.
You don't have to.
Oh, yeah. Like, you really expect me to say yes without sifting out the details? No way. He's liable to take you to an outdoor meeting of the Young Republicans.
It's not politics, Mom. It's just a hunting trip.
A hunting trip? As in with a gun that shoots bullets and terminates life? Well, then that's easy. No.
But you didn't even think about it.
I didn't have to. It's a vile sport. In fact, it's not even a sport. It's a sadistic pastime. A mindless celebration of violence and animus. And there is no way on earth that I will
Peter
ever...
Peter said that it builds character.
Yeah. Look at the kind of character it built him. Honestly, I'm surprised at you, Bobby. I think of you as a lot of things. Never as a butcher.
Maybe we can trade or something. Like when you let me see that Adam Sandler movie when I went with you to see La Boheme.
Right.
A quid
pro quo.
That's
yeah.
It.
Well, no way, because you don't have anything big enough to trade for this.
I can help you with your secret.
Secret? What secret?
You know about you and Tom.
My secret's just fine, thank you.
You still don't want Jack to find out about it, right?
No, not yet.
He could. by accident.
Are you?
Hey, Jack.
Hey. I just saw Tom outside. He said to remind you about some kind of surprise thing for class tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Thanks.
Why, Mom? Are you doing something with Tom tomorrow?
What's going on?
Your brother's going on a hunting trip this weekend, and I just hope that he feels good about what he's doing.
Hunting? What's next? A monster truck rally? Or I know, how about a tour of all of the St. Louis strip clubs?
I'm sorry, these are related how exactly?
Testosterone.
Oh, testosterone.
Yeah, yeah, mindless macho rituals that indulge men's taste for blood and their primitive urge to exert dominion over things.
You know, we're going hunting. We're not annexing Poland. Have you ever been hunting?
Oh, please, of course not.
Of course not. So you probably wouldn't know that for some of us, it's not entirely about the kill, it's about connecting. To the outdoors, to each other, to the history of human beings.
Really? If you want to commune with nature, fine, go shoot some pictures. But please, just don't get my son excited about the needless slaughter of animals.
Are you a vegetarian?
You know I'm not. I said needless. The fact that we can actually buy meat in stores is precisely why I'm against hunting. It's no longer necessary. It's just entertainment.
No, that's actually not the case with white-tailed deer. You see, the population's exploded, their food supply is down, so either we hunt them and eat them, or we let them starve to death in the woods.
Peter, please, you don't know Bobby. This kind of thing runs completely counter to his nature. Bobby's, he's sensitive, he's poetic.
He's tougher than you think.
Oh, yeah? If there's a spider in the house, he makes me take it outside in a cup.
Hey, look, the kid asked me to come incessantly. Now, maybe he's tired of being squeamish, or just maybe he's developed interests beyond yours.
Don't you see? It's not the hunting he cares about, it's you. For no discernible reason, and despite my repeated protestations, he insists upon seeing you as a male worth emulating. I know. He would want to go to a macrame seminar if you thought it was cool.
Well, lucky for you, I just like killing stuff.
Peter, please, I'm asking you. Just tell Bobby he can't come.
You tell him. You're his mother. Why am I even having this conversation?
It's complicated, okay?
Look, the kid invited himself. I expected you to say no, so say no. If you don't, I'm going to take him. Because I actually think it'd be good for him. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm late.
Watch me roll this guy's head off. Whoa, headshot. Can't believe you're going to actually get to shoot a real gun. Oh, what kind, Uzi? RPG? I don't know. Whatever the heck you hunt with. There's a market right there.
No, wait, wait. Where is he?
You should have grenaded that guy. Friendly fire. Uh-oh. My uncle went hunting once, accidentally shot a part of his ear.
No way.
Yeah. Now he can't even put in both of his iPod headphones. It's like this big family tragedy.
He obviously didn't know what he was doing. Peter does.
All I know is if I were going, I'd, like, set up a bomb or a booby trap. Deer comes by, splash.
That misses the whole point.
I thought the point was to kill deer.
It is, but you're supposed to make it challenging. Killing an animal is an art. It connects you with your ancestors. Peter said so.
Eat that, biatch!
Awesome.
Shocking how much food you can eat. I was afraid you were gonna start gnawing on my fingernails after.
Ha. Well, I have a few years left before I rush a sorority and become a career bulimist. In case you were wondering, if you feed me, you do get to kiss me after. Rules are rules. Okay, if I didn't know I was a genius kisser, I'd start to worry.
Just keep waiting for the cops to come crashing in.
Yeah, I know. I called them like 20 minutes ago. I was really hoping for a quicker response time. Look, I'm 16 and you're 18. Technically, this isn't illegal.
Well, it shouldn't be.
Yo, Nate, I just got the invite to the Kappa Pledge party. House full of hot drunk chicks who have to do anything the girls tell them. Sorry.
So you didn't see the sock on the door? Can you believe he's valedictorian of his class?
Yeah, so I guess you have plans for Saturday.
Actually, I was thinking about hanging out with you.
I can't really compete with a house full of hot, drunk Kappas.
No, you do okay.
Well, we could hang out at my house if you wanted.
You do realize you have a dad. One who can have me pitched out of school with one well-worded email.
Not this weekend, I don't. He's headed out of town. Some hunting trip he does. Comes back with a huge bag full of Bambi steaks. It's kind of disgusting, but it gets him out of our way for Saturday.
Excuse me. Sorry.
Unless that book's translated from the Russian, it's not gonna get you through the wait.
At least it's cozy in here.
The motorcycle accident guy with the Franken arm came in. He's getting his pins pulled. It took the entire team.
Nasty.
You gonna wait it out?
Not much option.
There's always an option.
Where are you going?
Hobble with me. Find out.
So this is where you play hooky.
I like it here. My friends and I come at night sometimes, get drunk, try and do loops on the swings.
Never works, does it?
Not yet. One day.
So can I ask you something? If you were skipping out of there today, were you just waiting for me?
Don't flatter yourself. I was just picking up a prescription.
Oh.
And maybe I was waiting for you a little. You just seem pretty beat up lately.
It's because I keep getting beat up.
I knew there was a reason.
I'm just not sure what I'm supposed to be doing with myself.
Maybe you're asking the wrong question. Looks like you're always trying to do what you're supposed to do. Question is, what do you want to do?
I have no idea.
Well, you could bum my friends if you want. Actually, they probably wouldn't even notice. It's the advantage of being stoned half the time.
All the time?
If you're up for slumming it, you pretty much just hang out at this guy Stump's garage. It's a dump, and they've got, like, roaches that big, but no one bugs us.
Who's us?
Us is the band. Dumb Blonde.
Good name.
We don't actually play any gigs or anything. We just have fun. We sit around jamming, making up dumb lyrics.
Sounds like a good time.
It's time anyway. You gotta do something with it, right?
Can you believe it?
A lot of undergrads don't understand, Foucault. A lot of grads, too. We have no excuse.
No. I mean about Bobby.
Oh, I thought we were over that.
How can I be over my son going out into the woods to blithely blow the heads off wildlife?
Do you ever actually let anything go? I mean, wait, what am I saying? Look, we gotta take your mind off this.
I have a right to be perturbed about this.
And I have a right to gag you with a sock if I have to hear this again. Can we please change the subject?
Oh, okay, so you don't think that firearms training is inappropriate for a 12-year-old? No, that's interesting
that's
to
it.
Me.
Sorry, I had to take action. Better the sock.
It wasn't so bad. Still, Bobby, I mean, he's out there. He's with
Where's the Bennett. Craziest place you've ever done it?
You're right. We should really just go back to grading papers.
My God, are you blushing?
No, I'm not blushing.
Wait, what happened to the wacky free spirit you always market yourself as?
Okay, fine. 15,000 feet, Tibetan plateau.
Okay.
I was backpacking through Asia with my boyfriend after college, and there were Sherpas and Yaks in the valley below. Lamaist monks chanting out their prayers. The air was thin. I nearly fainted. Your turn.
Okay. You beat mine. Mm-hmm. How about in front of the fireplace?
No, I haven't managed that one yet.
Yeah, how about now?
Yeah, right.
Or, I mean, I'd settle for the couch.
What?
What? Bobby's over at Warren's house. Jack's gonna be at the doctor's appointment to what, 5:30?
What, you memorized my children's schedules?
In the name of kinky sex, I did, yes. God. Come on, you know how doctor's office always make us wait. 5:30's conservative.
Wait. What?
Come on, we have an hour minimum.
Wait. Oh.
Let's create a memory. Come on, we're gonna look back on this in years. And we're gonna think. And we're gonna think. We'll just smile, because in the end, that's what we got.
Okay. Just wait. Hold on 1 second. Okay, I'll be down literally in 1 second.
Right. Is this my surprise?
Pick a room.
Okay. You're not running out of me, are you?
No, just give me a minute. Ho! Or, two.
Come on! Clock is ticking.
Read a magazine or something!
Yeah, no, I'll just grade all these midterms while I'm half naked. Come on, if I don't have sex with you right now, I'm gonna go nuts. Come on, get that sexy ass of yours down here.
I'm coming. Where are you? Oh my God. Are you ready for your surprise? Huh? Oh my God. Oh.
Must be a hell of a thesis.
It's getting pretty cold, huh? Can we just go that way?
Yeah, we could if we don't want a deer hunt. We have to go into the wind so the deer won't smell us.
Yeah, but we're wearing bright orange. Wouldn't they just see us anyway?
Deer can't see color, only contrast. And the orange is so that Bill and Marty and all the other hunters won't mistake us for a buck. Oh, there's a deer trail right there.
How do you know that's a deer trail?
Chewed leaves, trampled sawgrass, and... deer droppings. Pretty fresh. I'd say a deer's been through here in the last 20 minutes. Chocolate covered peanut? It's an old hunter's gag. Yeah. When my dad did that to me, I almost lost my lunch. Come on.
Hey, here's a sandwich there if you want. Jack, please talk to me.
I don't want a sandwich.
About yesterday.
Still uninterested.
You've been avoiding me all day. You can't just keep ignoring me. Jack?
You're under your TA. He lied to me about it, and then I come home to find him naked in our dining room. What's there to discuss?
Okay. You're allowed to be angry. I understand.
Yeah? You grant me permission.
But you also don't fully understand.
Why? So is it complicated? Are you two in love? Because even if you are, which I highly doubt, given that you're you, this whole thing is just weird and wrong. And you clearly know it is, or you wouldn't be keeping it a secret.
It's a secret because of how other people think, not because I'm ashamed of it.
Right. Of course, you have your own moral compass. But what about when people do find out? The boring ones who pay your salary, what then? How are we gonna eat when you get fired?
Oh, they're not gonna fire me. That's absurd.
Jeez, what if Bobby finds out? Have you given any thought to him? What the hell were you thinking? You lie to me over and over, and you get your 13-year-old to cover up for you? You're not just lonely, you're sick.
Okay. What if I am in love? No. I mean,
Is it selfish to want to be happy?
If it humiliates all of us, yes. This guy's like 8 years older than me. Are you really this deluded?
Okay, never mind.
What did you think was going to happen? Forget it. He was going to move into the house and be our new dad, or you guys were going to ride off into the sunset together?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
This whole thing's going to tank. And when it does, you're going to be more of a mess than you usually are. Now I have to pick up the pieces. Again.
Did you always want to be college president?
No, I wanted to be a saxophone player.
Really? How long did you play?
I didn't. I just really loved the old jazz records I grew up listening to. I pictured myself like Charlie Parker or somebody, playing in some smoky club till dawn, living the life of an artist.
Why didn't you try?
Not really an option for me. My father ran a dry goods store. I come from practical people. I'm a practical person.
So, do you regret it, not playing the saxophone?
No, not really. After a while, you realize it's not what you are, it's who you are. Our jobs are important, but they don't have to define us.
So is that why you hunt? Because it's so different from what you are?
You mean a straight-laced, white-collar bean counter? Yeah, that might be part of it. I also think that modern life's become too convenient in some ways. I mean, it's only the last blink of our evolutionary history you could pull into a drive-thru and get a burger without any idea whatsoever where it came from. See it?
Yeah, I see her. Feeding strays.
Is this not cool?
Didn't expect to see you here.
Didn't expect to be here.
What happened? Uh-huh. Bump into your ex Barbie doll and her soon-to-be date rapist again?
No, I walked in on my mom and her new boyfriend.
Fun.
Like my age.
Really fun. But at least your knee is in excruciating pain.
Actually, that I don't mind so much. Right now, it's the one thing I can count on. I wake up, I know it's gonna hurt like a bitch, but...
Wow. I didn't know guys like you got that dark. Luckily, we have a fix here. Mo, pass it. You've been making that face all week. Take a break. You could use one.
Not really my speed. My mom's kind of a pot addict.
Like 12-step?
She's still working on the first. I grew up with a cloud of smoke around my living room. I've been around way too many stone people to ever think it could be fun.
Sometimes you need a break. Plus, it's nice to lose the inhibitions occasionally. Get brave enough to face the day. Flirt with the cute guy you see at physical therapy.
You checking in?
I'm good.
If you want to stop, just say so. I was actually wondering when I'd get to pull my Kill Bill set out of my backpack.
You actually brought it?
Anytime you want, Joe. Just let me know. I mean, if all we do is make out until my lips are swollen and your chin is red from my scruff, that's all we do, I'm a lucky guy.
No, I like this. I just...
It's okay, really.
No, it's not that. I just, I want you to stop treating me like I'm made of glass.
16-year-old glass.
Okay, you're 20 months older than me.
20 and a half.
You keep making jokes like that, but if we're gonna be doing this, you have to stop looking at me like I'm one of those antiques downstairs. I'm not part of the museum.
Good, because I'm having a really hard time trying to stop myself here.
And I don't want you to hold back with me. There's already enough fragile crap in this house.
See her.
See her.
Okay.
Get your gun out.
Steady. Just breathe. Wait till you feel it.
I want to make sure you're cool with this.
You've got protection, right?
No, I didn't think we'd be doing this. I could just pull out, okay?
Okay.
She's down. We got her.
What's wrong? Why is she doing that?
Looks like you shattered her shoulder.
What are we gonna do?
You gotta kill her.
What?
Shoot her again, Bobby. Hurry up.
This close?
Come on, pick up your gun.
I can't.
Hey.
Hey.
How you doing? How's Jack?
Oh, terrific. We had a very healthy chat. He's disgusted and possibly scarred for life.
Oh, Grace.
He thinks I'm immature and pathetic and unfit to be a parent. And you know what? He's right. I should have told him. I mean, what kind of mother lets her son come home to find her 20-something lover capering around in his underwear?
I wasn't capering, and those were briefs.
Oh, yeah, this is all very humorous, isn't it?
But once you get past the initial stomach churning, it's kind of funny.
Oh, yeah, it is.
I mean, we were just being impulsive. When Jack's older, he'll realize that. I think he'll tell the story in a bar, and all of his buddies, they'll just laugh their asses off.
Yeah, well, you don't know my son.
Fine, then he'll write a book, and he'll expose you. For wanting to enjoy your life. Or whatever.
No, see, this is exactly what happens. You get close to me, and I can't think rationally anymore. I stop thinking like a mother, and I start thinking like a...
A woman?
Yeah.
You're allowed to be both, Grace. This time, you just... We screwed up a little bit.
All right. I guess you're right.
Yeah, that happens sometimes.
Oh, you know, one other regret from yesterday is that you never got your surprise.
Oh, yeah, you're still gonna make me wait for it?
Let's just say if disaster hadn't struck, we could have gone au naturel. Yep, a diaphragm. Okay, you do seem surprised, but just not quite in the way I expected.
We're still gonna have to practice safe sex.
Right, well, I believe the custom is to wait 6 months after a previous partner.
Mm-hmm.
But, and we've been together for half of that, but if you think that we still need to wait the additional, you know, full 3 months, that's fine. Or 4 or 5 more. Tom, just exactly how long should I expect to wait?
We never really talked about, you know, being exclusive.
Right, right, so. And how many people do you think I'm seeing?
None, but we didn't discuss it.
Are you, I mean, are you... You seeing somebody else now?
No, of course not.
But since we've been together, have you? Right. Okay. Let's see.
But we weren't. Wait. We weren't official then. We're official
now.
Oh
no, no! How lucky for me.
Grace. Please don't.
What? Be surprised? No, you're right. I shouldn't be.
Oh wait. Come on. That was like 2 months ago.
Two months ago. I was crazy about you. Clearly, a mistake.
Don't. Come on, that's not true. Don't say that. talk to me, please.
You know, I need to prep my lecture for Monday. Would you mind closing the door behind you?
Come on. We're together now.
Please, just...
It was brutal, but the urban lethal gun ban managed to pass the Congress. And as I expected, Bobby had to veto. It was fantastic. The press nailed him to the wall. How could the all-compassionate McCallister kill a law that would greatly reduce gun violence in our cities? And 3 days after the veto, he had a press conference in Baltimore when she stood up. Mrs. Marlena Johnson, mother of three, pulled a pistol out of her purse and shot him.
Okay, so you're just in for your annual?
No, I was told I could come here to get a morning after pill.
Are you currently sexually active?
Yes.
Are you currently using any birth control? There are no circumstances under which it is okay to have unprotected sex. Condoms are necessary not only to prevent pregnancy, but also STDs. Now, if you need to discuss
this... Look, I had a condom and it broke, and... Do you have the morning after pill here?
Yes, we can help you with that. I don't have your student ID number here.
I don't have one.
But you're a student at the university.
No. I have university insurance, though. My father's faculty.
That's fine. Ah, they don't even have your name. I'll just do this. What's your last name?
This is confidential, right?
Of course.
Benedict. Courtney Benedict.
Take him to a local guy I know who'll butcher him and give us the meat.
I'm sorry.
For what? You haven't disappointed me, if that's what you're worried about. You know, my dad used to say you go into the woods to learn about yourself, find out who you are.
Well, I wish I was someone else.
Bob, you don't know that yet. You're still becoming who you are. All we know at this point is that you're not someone who kills easily, which is not a bad thing. The rest we'll just have to wait and see.
I couldn't stand the guy, but I didn't want to see him dead. Which for a moment there, we all thought he was. Stone still on the floor, Secret Service diving all over the place, tackling Johnson. Kind of insanity that 10,000 people train every day to prevent. It was Marks who first saw him twitch, pulled everybody off. And then we realized Mrs. Johnson had shot the president with an SV-5. First non-lethal presidential assassination attempt.
Hello?
You don't have to announce yourself every time you come home now. Hey.
We already had the conversation.
I know. Just somehow in the thick of it, I believe I forgot to say that, I'm sorry.
You said that part?
No, actually, I tried to justify my behavior on poetic grounds. I want to apologize. My mistakes are mine to make repeatedly, it seems, but, I don't have to bring them into the house.
Good.
You were right, you know. I've been completely ridiculous. I don't know how I let myself get so caught up in what was clearly, well, it's certainly not the smartest thing I've ever done.
It's not the worst either.
I actually think it might be.
God, why can't you act like a normal person?
What's that supposed to mean?
One minute you're totally into this guy, like dining room table into him, and the next minute you're hating yourself for liking him. Which is it?
I don't know.
Well, figure it out already. I mean, this whole thing is completely screwed up. But you're allowed to be happy too, I guess.
Thank you, Jack. So are you, by the way.
I'm getting there. The Great Short Hunter returns. How was it?
Awesome.
Yeah, sure sounds like it. Did you kill anything fun?
Mm-hmm.
Like what?
A deer.
How many shots?
Two. Stop asking so many questions.
Annoying, isn't it?
Hey, Bobby?
I gotta talk to him.
Thank you.
Wasn't as much fun as you thought it'd be, huh? Tell me about it. One time me and Marcus thought it'd be fun to try and pick off crows with his dad's slingshot. We finally hit one, but we were both so freaked out, we just took off and ran straight back to his... Yeah?
I really just want to go to bed, okay?
Okay. Night, Bobby.
Marlena Johnson, mother of three. But she had been the mother of four. Her 12-year-old son had been killed 6 months earlier, caught in a police crossfire. He was riding the tram to school, took a bullet in the heart. And Mrs. Johnson was trying to show the world and Bobby that a non-lethal weapon could have the same impact and no one had to die. When the president came to at the hospital and they told him what happened, who she was, the bastard granted her clemency right on the spot. Still, he was left with the political fallout from his veto. I know that hurt him. Sometimes, everybody loses.